Welcome to Meadowwalk's Rehabilitation Unit. You'll share a room, as we find it's much easier for our patients to share their experience with someone else.
Like a chest of hidden gold, shimmers in the depths below. We are, our blazing hearts will burn it down. We are, soldiers of light, and we will glow.
Oh, I'm not going to lie to you, Steve. You're in for a bumpy ride.
Days. I know it's a long time, sweetheart, but I know how much Dee loves you. And if he knows you're going to wait for him and marry him...
Yeah, I didn't say that for definite, Anna.
Oh, you having second thoughts?
They said you're allowed to wear makeup.
I don't care what they say. I've been locked in this place for a whole week. It's like cell block H. And if I want to look devastating, then I will. You never know who's going to walk through that door.
Well, look at the state of you two.
Bullshit!
Well, don't just sit there with your gob open. Can you best cousin a kiss?
Blimey, is there anything left on the boat?
Well, I couldn't visit the family empty-handed now, could I? And besides, I work for peanuts behind the bar. A few little extras is the least I could do.
This for Mercedes, yeah?
Oh, Ziff. She'd never fit into that. It's for Nana.
Oh!
Give them a good old show next time you're down the beach in Magaluf.
Don't need the bra, love.
Really?
And this little beauty is for our calm.
Oh.
When she gets back.
Right, well, our police protection guy's waiting, so I'll shoot off. But I'll see you later. You can tell me all about your cruising exploits.
Yeah, likewise. Carmel's coming back. I promise.
Don't, or I'll be in bits. Now out with it. I know you're here for a reason. So what's really going on?
Want to tell the family when they're all together?
Well, you're going to have a long wait. They've stopped me from discharging myself. All that red tape, I'll be here for I don't know how long.
Right, well, they can shove the red tape. You finish putting on your slap and leave the rest to me.
Oh.
Now then, sweet cheeks. I'll show you mine.
You show me yours.
Oh, Pips. How about you start without me?
I'm Roger. So how'd you get on with the psychiatrist last night?
Well, I wasn't in the mood to have a shrink fire loads of questions at me.
Yeah, well, I'm not going to be doing that now. You can say as much or as little as you like, all right? Come on. Come and sit down. Yeah. Right. I'd like you all to welcome our newest guest, Steve.
Steve?
I'm Steve.
Let's start with you, Steve. Tell us something about yourself.
I'm Steve.
Hi, Steve.
So I can't do this, sorry.
If I didn't know better, I'd see you doing the walk of shame.
Yeah, well, you do know me better. And I'm going home to my own bed. Shame there's no one keeping it warm for you. What, you think as soon as Steve's back's turned, I'm just going to become the village bitch? I'm sorry. I just think it's rubbish that you have to carry on all his baggage when all he cares about is... Like, I've been there. I know. Any excuse to fail and I'll throw it away. Best thing to do is let him... Get on with it, fight his demons, and you'll live your own life. I'm sure there's plenty of guys dying to help you spread your wings. I need to go. And you deserve better.
Taxi for McQueen?
Got the wrong room, love. Portia, what are you playing at? Where did
you get?
Trust me, you don't want to know. Come on then, hop on board.
Ed, if we get home quick, we might get in time for Murder, She Wrote.
Yeah, but you can't just wheel me past reception.
I can if you're dead.
Oh, I'm dead?
Oh, it is so good to hear your voice.
Yeah, you too. Look, there's something I need to say to you.
I didn't want to say it over the phone.
What? John Paul, you're scaring me.
Look, I know that it was you that spiked me.
No, I never meant for you to take it, though. I swear, I never would...
I know you'd never do anything intentionally to hurt me.
It's just...
Are you going to leave me?
You say that like you want it to happen.
No, I don't.
I know you, remember? And I love you.
And I know that you probably feel guilty as hell right now, which is why I forgive you.
You forgive me? After that, but you... John Paul, I nearly killed you.
I want you to come out of that unit in 28 days, and I want you to make good on your promise.
I don't want to be the reason that you fail.
It's just so hard. It's really hard for me.
Well, you don't think this is hard for me?
You've hurt me time and time again with your addiction, but I'm still here. I'm telling you that I love you.
Don't you dare give up on us.
You understand?
All right to be home.
I've never been more sure of anything. Now stop fussing and fetch me that remote. I've been dying to have a good flick all
week.
Give me
a ring back once you get this message. I got off the boat early, especially to meet you.
Right, somebody's getting an earful. You still haven't told us your news yet. Sounds really juicy.
Oh, I'm waiting for Auntie Mary to get back so I can tell you all together. Mm. I bet she's run away with that bodyguard.
She better not if she's got my son with her.
When were you going to tell me about Steve? Drugs? What the hell were you playing at?
I know it was a stupid thing to do, but I'm not an addict or anything, okay? So you can just drop it.
Yeah, I'll drop it once you drop the everything's fine act. Come on, this is me. The one that forced you into that drag club when Craig left you in Dublin. If you need to cry...
If I start, I won't stop.
Well... Let's dance the pain away.
Dance? Look, are you joking? I just got out of hospital.
Come on.
I'm exhausted.
A few Sambucas and Jerry Hallowell will fix that. Come on, I'm going to put on my dancing shoes and you are going to meet me down the pub in 20 minutes. Come on, off you pop. No arguments.
Look, I know you. I know that you'd never do anything intentionally to hurt me. That's why I forgive you. I want you to come out of that unit in 28 days, and I want you to make good on your promise. Don't you dare give up on us.
What have I done?
You did the right thing telling us, Steve.
Get off me!
Look, I know you don't realise it, but what you just did was a massive step in your rehabilitation.
Not by grassing somebody up.
No. They were right there in front of you. Then you walked away.
I opened the back though. I had them right here. Right in my hands. And I have never wanted anything as bad in my entire life.
What about him, eh?
I have to make this work. Because if I don't, then he'll leave me. And if that happens, I might as well give up on everything.
Don't tell me you took my advice. Why are you always running away from me?
You scared of something?
What have I got to be scared of, Lockie?
Well, it's either that or I've got B.O.
No, fresh as a daisy. So why won't you let me buy you a pint? Come on, let me tempt you.
What is it with you?
Hey, you're always there with a cheeky smile and a funny little comment, aren't you? You speak to me like I'm a coward. Like I'm scared to live my own life. So I tell you what, why don't you take your own advice? Come on, out with it. What is it that you want, Lockie?
I want you, John Paul. In my bed. Right now.
Oh, what time do you call this? I was going to send out a search party.
You're the one that's kept me waiting all day.
Sorry, you two know each other?
Noah?
She's my fiancée.